I'm Marcel Beugelsdijk from the Netherlands, owner of a mint and specialized in Power Query. This video is about the Power Query M Functions dashboard you can find on the site of the Power BI community. The homepage, you can scroll down to the galleries and the data stories gallery. Currently the report is under recently posted, but I'm sure it will be a featured report shortly. If you open the reports, you arrive on a page where you can scroll down and leave your appreciation and reply to the report. But if you want to use it, it is better to have it stabilized and switch to full screen mode. And then you get this report, and it's not possible to scroll it off the screen anymore. In this report, you can find all Power Query functions, more specifically the Power Query functions in the Power BI desktop version mentioned on the disclaimer and explanation page. Click on the page numbers and choose disclaimer and explanation. Current version is of December 2017. And also notice that all information is derived from the data in the Sharp Shared Record in Power Query, meaning that all data is provided by Microsoft in Power BI Desktop. On the Functions dashboard page, you can search for functions and get all available information of the selected function. For instance, if I search on week, then I get these results with all the functions that have a week in the name. And I choose date end of week as an example. I'll explain what you see on the screen. First, all parameter information. So the syntax, the parameters and parameter values are directly derived from the function specifications. So these are highly reliable. Some parameters may have a list of allowed values, like the first day of week parameter in this example, which is specified as a nullable date type with allowed values in this visual. Otherwise, you can see the parameter date time as any, which may seem a little bit strange for a date function. But if you switch to about this function and go to focus mode, first click the visual and then you can choose the focus mode. You can provide date, date time or date time zone values as value types for parameter date time. Another example is if I search on select, then I get this result. Text.select is quite interesting as this is a new function added in the December 2017 release of Power BI Desktop. Although it is not mentioned in the Power BI Desktop December feature summary. There's nothing about a new function in Power Query. And also, if you switch to the Power Query M function reference on the Microsoft Developer Network, go to the text functions, then you won't find the text.select function. So the dashboard really includes all functions. And if a new version of Power BI Desktop is released, I just need to refresh the queries and publish it again. Various data access functions have some additional information, like SQL database. If you check the parameters, then there is an options parameter with a nullable record, which is fully specified in the column custom list or a record. Another example with additional parameter information is vsts.views. Focus mode of the parameters visual. There you can see the captions, sample values, and descriptions provided with parameters. So the dashboard page is very useful to search and get all information for a particular function. On the functions list page, you find a complete overview of all available functions with their descriptions, if there is a description. From this page, you can drill through the function details. Let's take as an example just the date time zone function. Right click, drill through functions dashboard, which is not quite ideal. because you go to the first page back again that is still selecting on a VSTS. So you first have to remove the selection criteria, then you can choose the function that was selected on the previous page. But now all other functions are gone, and the only way to reset the drill through filter is to refresh the entire page in your browser. The function syntax page is also a complete list of all functions together with their syntax. On the next page, you find function parameters and where these parameters are used. For instance, if I select start at end, this parameter is used in various splitter functions. Other parameters you might be looking for are, for instance, comparison criteria, which is quite specific parameter, which is used in these functions, or the parameter missing field can also be interesting, which states what should be done with fields or columns that are referenced but are not available in the table or in the record. And this parameter is used in these record and table functions. The next page displays all the types that are available in the Sharp shared record. Some of them are just copies of primitive types in Power Query, like any type and binary type, except these types have a description associated with them. But other custom types have also a list of parameter values. This page also includes the functions that explicitly use this type. If a parameter is specified as, in this case, a binary encoding type, then the function is listed on this page. But there are other types like order.type, which is not explicitly used in any function because it is part of the sort functions. Select sort functions, list.sort, the comparison criteria parameter is order.descending in the second example, and actually this parameter comparison criteria can take on many formats as explained in the about this function information of list.sort. That's why no functions show up with order.type. The page named values is provided for completeness. It contains some specified values on the left-hand side and some obsolete parameter values on the right-hand side. They are obsolete for various reasons. I will not explain in this video. That is too much detail. This will be the end of the video. I hope you will appreciate the functions dashboard, and you may leave any comments on the Power BI community site. Thanks for watching, and see you again in another video about Power Query.